Hi there, and welcome to our 10 Under 10 series, where you get 10 must-know Schnauzer facts under 10 sweet minutes. Let's talk about ways you can extend your Schnauzer's life. So this is based on an article that gives you 24 ways that you might be able to extend your Schnauzer's life, and let's cover 10 in under 10 minutes today. So number one is brush your Schnauzer's teeth. This is really top of the list because it is one daily or at least 2 to 3 times weekly thing that you can do to really make a difference in her health. So brush your teeth. Number two is be careful with human food. There are many things, and again, you'll find this on our website, but there are many things that she or he should not even be eating at all that would be tempting to share if you didn't know they were dangerous. You know, I was tempted many times to share avocado, just thought it would be healthy, a nice healthy source of fat, and I was very wrong. There are some surprising things that you really need to know about in terms of what you eat every day that would be easy for you or your family or your kids to inadvertently share with your Schnauzer that you should just not. So be careful with human food. Number three is be careful with medication. Aspirin, ibuprofen are both toxic to your Schnauzer, and even if they're in pain, obviously check with your veterinarian and get clear about what types of pain relievers they can prescribe for your Schnauzer, but do not give her any type of human medication. It's incredibly dangerous and poisonous. Number four is to buckle up. You know, none of us would let our kids roam around the car while we're driving, and really every single dog, in my opinion, should be buckled up in some type of restraint. There are plenty on the market for you to choose from, and it keeps your Schnauzer safe, and it keeps him or her from being a real distraction and danger to you as you're driving. So number four is buckle up. Number five is if you have a large Schnauzer, a giant Schnauzer, or if your Schnauzer is getting up in years and is considered a senior and seems to be having a little harder time jumping or getting around, really consider a therapeutic bed. And frankly, you may want to get one sooner than later, even if your Schnauzer is still young or even an adult, because Schnauzers are known for some joint problems, a tendency to some forms of arthritis, and even hip dysplasia, which can all make it really tough for them to feel good when they're laying down so much and just relaxing by you. So invest in a therapeutic bed. They can be a little bit pricey, but really for the comfort and the ease on your Schnauzer's joint, it can be something that extends their life and helps them be comfortable as they age. All right, so number six is be aware of any bad odor. You know, we are all familiar with that wet dog smell, and we won't get into that today, but there is a specific reason behind that. In addition to just regular stinky dog smell that we are all used to once in a while, be aware of something that just smells a little off, because if it's persistent and you can't get rid of it with, you know, regular bathing or regular brush teething, teeth brushing, then there may be a problem. There may be an abscess tooth that's, you know, finally crossed that line, or an infection elsewhere on your Schnauzer's body or in her system. So stay alert to bad smells that just don't go away. What are we on? Six, make sure you spay or neuter. Boy, I'm blowing this. Make sure you spay or neuter your Schnauzer. I remember reading a long time ago a fair amount of controversy about spaying or neutering, whether it was cruel, and I'm sure there are mixed opinions out there, but Schnauzers are a little prone, female Schnauzers I should say, are a little prone to a buildup of just aspects of their menstrual cycle that does not flush completely if they go through several menstrual cycles. If you're breeding, that's one thing, but if you are not planning to have puppies or breeding at all, you really should spay or neuter your Schnauzer. I know our Livy, because we kept her in the house and she was just kind of a small house dog with us, we really put it off for several years, and she ended up with a very serious uterine infection, and it frankly, we caught it just in time, and she survived, but it can be dangerous. There are all sorts of reasons for spaying and neutering, but that's a tip that you should, you know, do some research and take to heart. It can help extend their life and cause them to be a little healthier in the long run. Number 8 is get your dog out and socialized with people, other animals, dog parks, friendly dogs, or even cats in your own neighborhood. Don't let them shy away from getting to know your extended family member or friends. Like all of us, really, your Schnauzer needs companionship. Schnauzers were bred on German farms and are really, kind of as a breed, very used to being with families and being part of the family, frankly, and they need people and those relationships to maintain a good level of, I don't know, emotional and mental, psychological health. So keep her involved with people out at pet parks, dog parks, and just in touch with other people and pets that can keep her happy and active socially. Number 9 is, in addition to social stimulation, she really, or he, needs a lot of mental stimulation to really be happy and healthy for the long term. Schnauzers are an intelligent breed. Miniature Schnauzers are in the top 12. Standard Schnauzers are in the top 22. Giant Schnauzers are in the top 35. I mean, these are smart dogs. And we have found that treat puzzles, new games — our Schnauzer doesn't like toys, but we have introduced the things I've mentioned, treat puzzles, new types of games, maybe a new sport like agility training or barn hunting, whatever you might be able to find organized in your neighborhood or your area would be perfect for a Schnauzer, just to keep him or her really actively and mentally engaged, and keep them sharp, because they are an intelligent breed that really love it. And number 10 is to consider a microchip. You know, we didn't do this for a long time either, but we decided when we moved that it would be a good idea, because Livy ran away a couple of times. I think she was trying to adjust to a new home, a new environment, a new neighborhood, and she ran away. So we did have her microchipped. It is a very simple process that includes a microchip that is about the size of a grain of rice, and it's injected just like an injection, for example, a vaccine would be, through a syringe in kind of a fatty loose part right between her shoulders. So it's quick, it's painless, and then you're entered into a database and can subscribe to that service, not so much to monitor their every movement, but the idea is if your Schnauzer is lost and returned to a veterinarian or a hospital, they can scan her and access the information on file that includes your contact information and an identifier for the Schnauzer, so they know who she or he is and how to contact you. So those are 10 ways to keep your Schnauzer alive for longer, healthy, doing well. Visit our website for the rest of them. We have a total of 24, and other articles that can help you keep your Schnauzer healthy and active. And we will see you here next time. Okay, so there you have it, my friends. For more in-depth information and articles, visit our website, theschnauzercollective.com, and as always, happy schnauzering!